Hey guys, today we'll discuss about anti-rheumatoid drugs. So these are the group of drugs which is used in rheumatoid arthritis. So here I have majorly written about two groups of drugs, biological therapy and DMARDs, okay? So we'll discuss how they will work. Before that, let's understand basic concept of rheumatoid arthritis, a basic pathophysiology of it, okay? So during rheumatoid arthritis, what will happen? We have lymphocytes. We have some cells called TH1 and TH17 cells, and we have plasmocytes. So all these cells, what they will do, they will infiltrate into synovial membrane. So they will go to synovial membrane. Then what will happen? They will stimulate synovial macrophages. So whenever synovial macrophages are stimulated, what they will cause, they will lead to the production of interleukins, tumor necrotic factors, and there are many other cells such as fibroblast activation. So they will lead to production of interleukins. So that includes interleukin 1, interleukin 6, and tumor necrotic factor alpha, and they also activate fibroblast activation. So these fibroblasts and many other cells will be activated. Why I am telling this is a very very basic pathophysiology of rheumatoid arthritis, so that we can understand where we use these drugs actually, okay? So actually, when you have a patient with rheumatoid arthritis, you will start treating him with a group of drugs called as NSAIDs. So we use group of drugs such as NSAIDs, and we'll use corticosteroids. But still, we use these group of drugs, they are special group of drugs which are used in rheumatoid arthritis. So what is DMARDs? DMARDs is nothing but disease modifying anti-rheumatoid drugs. So these are the drugs which will decrease the progression of the disease, but they won't cure the disease. They just decrease the course and they will decrease the damage. And the biological therapy also the same thing, but they are against some factors whatever involved in the pathophysiology of rheumatoid arthritis. So first we'll discuss about methotrexate. So what will happen, this methotrexate, so it is a drug which will cause immune suppression. So whenever we are giving methotrexate and it will lead to immune suppression, this immune suppression will lead to decreased production of T cells and B cells, and that is how they will decrease the symptoms of rheumatoid arthritis. Right? So this is a simple mechanism to understand. We should understand the side effect and what is the dosage used. There, the methotrexate is actually anti-cancerous drug, but still we use it in rheumatoid arthritis in a very low doses, right? So whenever there is an immune suppression, what will be the side effect of the drug? The drug will produce side effects such as pancytopenias, and it will also cause damage to liver. So this is a hepatotoxic drug. So what I mean by hepatotoxic, whenever I am giving methotrexate to a patient, I should monitor his liver enzyme levels. So this is about methotrexate. So then comes our other group of drug, that is hydroxychloroquine, right? So hydroxychloroquine is a group of drug which belongs to anti-malarial drug. It is an anti-malarial drug, but still a unknown mechanism of hydroxychloroquine what it will cause, it will decrease the immune system, and also it will decrease the symptoms of rheumatoid arthritis, right? And this hydroxychloroquine, it is also used in other autoimmune diseases for its one of the effect, that is it will decrease photosensitivity. What do I mean by photosensitivity? It is a sensitive to light. Whenever the patient is exposed to UV radiation, the patient will start to develop some kind of rashes or maybe some kind of allergic reaction. It will decrease that. So this is the effect of our hydroxychloroquine. We have some drugs such as, we'll come back to leflunomide later. We have some drugs such as minocycline, sulfasalazine, gold and d-penicillamine. They all are DMARDS but with a unknown mechanism. They all are DMARDS, which means disease modifying anti-rheumatoid drugs, but still they are unknown mechanism. Leflunomide. So we'll come to leflunomide. What this drug will do? We have some enzyme called dihydroorotate dehydrogenase. So it will inhibit this enzyme, dihydroorotate dehydrogenase. Whenever this enzyme is inhibited, what will happen? Effect of this, it will decrease the UVMP production. What is UVMP? Uridine monophosphate. Uridine monophosphate, it is a base pair, it is a nucleotide for the DNA formation. Whenever DNA is not there, there is no formation of the immune cells, that is B lymphocytes and T lymphocytes. So how this is involved? This UVMP is required for production of thiamine monophosphate. It is also a nucleotide. So if there is no UVMP, there is no TMP and there is no T cells or B cells produced. And this drug is also a hepatotoxic, and this will also cause what side effect? It will also cause a side effect such as pancytopenias, right? So we are done with this DMARDS. So how do we prescribe this DMARDS? Whenever I am giving a DMARDS to a patient, what I will do, I will add one of the corticosteroid to that patient. So that, see, if I give methotrexate to a person, what will happen? The methotrexate will start to show its effect after 2 or 3 weeks of its administration. So till then I will add corticosteroids. So it is an immunosuppressant. Only it will be, yes, like, you know, it will be for a withstanding till the effect of methotrexate or till the effect of DMARDS is produced, right? So methotrexate is hepatotoxic, and we should monitor liver enzymes and the pancytopenias. So if there is a pancytopenia, the patient can develop recurrent infections of bacteria, right? So we'll come back to biological therapy. So it's written here very clearly, they will damage the receptors of TNF-alpha. So tumor necrotic alpha factor was produced during activation of synovial macrophages. If that is receptors for the TNF-alpha is damaged, so there is no further stimulation of fibroblast. The same way, there are some drugs which includes infliximab, adalimumab, cetrazolimab and golimumab. This MAB indicates, it means monoclonal antibodies. So these drugs, what they will do, they are antibodies to the tumor necrotic factor alpha. So if they are antibodies to tumor necrotic factor alpha, they are like damaging tumor necrotic factor alpha. There is no prolongation of the disease, right? So here we have some drug called as rituximab. It is also an anti monoclonal antibody, but still what it will do, it is an anti B cell antibody, means there is no B cell activation. If there is no B cell activation, there is no plasma cell formation and there is no further activation of the synovial macrophages. And we have abatacept. This is a T cell activation inhibitor. The same way T cells was also infiltrating into the synovial, so that will inhibit the T cells and it will decrease the progression of the disease. And we have tocuzumab and anakimab. So these are like anti-leukotriene drugs. What they will do, they will inhibit interleukins. So they will inhibit interleukin 6 and interleukin 1. They were also involved in pathophysiology. I mean, they were also involved in the progression of the rheumatoid arthritis. So this is about anti-rheumatoid drugs. Thank you. Keep following.